Hallelujah, man of God. Mm. There is power in this house. Mm. The power of God can bring things that are so amazing. Even a house.
Even a house.
Even a house.
She has a house.
She has a house.
Somebody praise the Lord. Come on, somebody say the
praise.
You want to tell me this teaching is working?
It's working, man of God.
It's working.
It is working.
People are saying, let house appear.
Let house appear. And the house is appearing. Man of God, a very beautiful house, big rooms in a nice place where exactly she wanted the house. That is where the house was. Hallelujah.
This is a woman who a few months ago, she was just moving from one place to another.
Because she had an issue. For 2 years, man of God, she had an issue with her housing. It's not something we can say here, man of God, but it was a serious issue. Then it was kind of sorted out, but then the issue came back again. So 2 years she's been battling one issue, man of God, with her housing. Then she came to see you. And then you prayed a very short prayer. Man of God, you don't speak much.
Me? A short prayer.
Very short prayer. You said, don't worry, God will do it, or something like that. And then she thought, I mean, is that all?
She was waiting.
She wanted to move heaven and earth, but you didn't. So she said, okay. She believed. Very short prayer, because man of God, we have heard testimonies where you pray short prayers.
No, you know, she can read them. You know what she came? She came, she told me, man of God, this is a situation, these people are doing whatever it is. I asked her one simple question. I said, do you believe God can do it? She said, yes. I said, let the house appear. I said, do you believe the house can appear?
Yes.
Look here, how was the prayer? Can you remember that? Put your hand, how you put your hand on the table. How in the, you were in the table. So I ask her, I said, look at my eyes, and I said, do you believe the house can appear? Look how quick the prayer was. Yeah? I said, I put my, because we are too short. I ask her this question.
Yeah.
Let me repeat the prayer. Do you believe that God things are possible?
Yes.
Do you believe a house can appear?
Yes.
Do you believe?
Yes, I do believe.
Then let the house appear now. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Man of God.
That is why the prayer was what?
Short. Very short.
The prayer need was big.
Yes. But the prayer itself
was short. Which was powerful.
Powerful. Short but powerful.
That's called a shotgun. A shotgun prayer.
Amen.
Yes.
She said 3 weeks after that, she received a phone call, and that is it. House appeared.
Just a phone call.
Yeah, because she didn't also want to go in a very different area. You know, she wanted a house where she already is, and she wanted just around that vicinity. And she got a very beautiful house, big rooms, beautiful, and in the same vicinity. Man of God, no problem. She's very happy with the house.
She's settled.
She's settled.
I can even see it. She is settled. Come on, somebody give Jesus a mighty little praise. But she did not tell you that. They had told her it's going to be impossible. They were even planning to divide her family. But I told her, no, it's not going to happen. No. But we say, if a house is made of man, of stones, and whatever it is, it must be from the earth. And God says in the book of Genesis 1:19, let the dry land appear. And it was so. I command your house. I command your cars. I command your children. I command your husband, your wife, to appear in the name of Jesus. I command money to appear in the name of Jesus. Shout hallelujah. Those who are watching, you need to be here. Yes.
And man of God, that's why she wants to thank you. She's so happy and she wants to thank God. You know, and she believes in the anointing. And she said, you know, the anointing is here. I mean, there's no difference. If you don't get a miracle, check yourself.
That's what she said. If you don't get your miracle, check yourself. Turn to your neighbor, say, neighbor, check yourself. The anointing is here. The miracle is here. Yes, pastor, yes.
Yes, but that is what I'm saying, man of God.
Okay, yes.
Yes. So if you don't get your miracle, man of God, people come here. They get miracles. But people are still here. Nothing. So, the problem is not the anointing. Mm-hmm. The problem is
is you. Stretch your hands right now. Turn to your neighbor, say neighbor. Now I have understanding. I will no longer be sleeping when the bishop is preaching. Every sleeping devil, die by fire. Say with me, neighbor. Every form of absent-minded. That I'm in the church and I'm up in the village counting the chickens. That devil, die by fire. And you've been counting those eggs three times. Someone said hallelujah.
She wants to say thank you, man of God.
Yeah, yes.
I saw this seed.
Listen, you're saying something, yes.
Thank you, Bishop. Yes, as I saw this seed, Bishop, I believe this will be the last time I will ever move from place to place. It's not easy, to be honest with you, because people were actually plotting to separate me and my daughter. And the wife of my daughter's father, she was actually saying, oh, I work in a mental institute. I know how people would have got issues like that. When she was trying to put me in the same category as those who are in the mental institute, so she was the one who was trying to take my daughter away from me. Bishop, I didn't want to do that because I raised that child from when she was in my stomach. She came out. I did everything, Bishop. For him as the father to stand up and try to claim a child I have raised, and he never comes for birthday, he never comes for Christmas. When he comes with a gift, Bishop, he comes with a small gift. He comes to my house, I make him a cup of tea in my own house with my own sugar and tea bags. Oh, Bishop, no, I can't have that, Bishop. You see, Bishop, this man, he is really, he tried to blackmail me even with the social services where they went to his house, because his house is bigger than the one I was staying in. They are more educated, you know, they were saying they are more educated because they work in with mental people, and him, whatever he's doing now, I have no idea. So they were trying to make me look so bad, Bishop, to a point where I came and I spoke to you and you gave me instructions and you told me, okay, this is what I need you to do. But because you saw the other side of the woman, what she was planning to do, and you said it yourself, in my heart, I was thinking, where is this coming from? But when you said it, it validated it, that no, she was up to something. And I even went to First Lady, I spoke to her, she prayed with me. I just want to thank you for standing for me, because it was really, really hard. To be honest with you, Bishop was there. He would help me, Bishop. I was like, Bishop, I've got a problem. He would help me. And for me to stand up here right now and say it, I've been through a lot. And for God to give me this house, I've got a red kitchen with the red cupboards. I've always...
That's the kingdom church. Yes. Everything is just red.
Bishop, I've always said, if I get a house, I want a house with a red kitchen. And Bishop, the house, I can walk from one end to another end. I'm looking at it. My daughter's like, Mommy, is this our house? Are you sure? You know, when she's thinking, are we going to lose it again? But Bishop, I just want to thank God because he has seen me through. Even when I went through that, he has seen me through it. I kept on coming. I kept on putting on makeup, dressing up well. But knowing where I was coming, where I was going, I knew the situation I was in. But I just want to thank God and just let everybody know that don't give up on God, because he will never give up on you. He will never do that. And Bishop, I thank you so much just for standing up with me, just standing in there for me and praying for me, Bishop. As I am standing here right now, to be honest with you, I am in college. I am studying. I went to college. Other people had to pay a lot of money just to start to be in college. Bishop, I am in college. You prophesied here one time when the lady, she said, she came and she gave a testimony, Bishop. And you said, Sophie, you're going to be studying this way, the way this woman is studying here. You're going to be doing something with your life. You're going to be in college. Bishop, I brushed it off a bit. I was like, oh, Bishop, I tried college. But Bishop, I went, I applied. People paid money for them before they started anything. Mine was free. I applied for my student finance. Bishop, it was no problem. Everything just came the way it was supposed to come. Bishop, I just want to thank you for your prayers. I really, really do thank you. You never give up on us. You never do. You pray. Even sometimes us, when we don't put more effort, but you still push us and push us and push us. I am grateful, Bishop. I am so thankful. Thank you.
Stretch your hands, right? You know what? You see, you know what, thing, Pastor? I'm going to tell you something. You see, this lady, I know the hell she was going through. Guess what? You will see her serving. She will still be serving. She will still be serving God, standing on the door. Not crying. Sometimes, for me, I know, because she speaks to me. She will talk to me, speak to me, send me the message. And quite really, I knew God will come for her. Because despite of everything, she, and you know where she lives? She lives all the way East London, the other side, not around here. You know when you're crossing from East London, there is no straight train to here. And imagine she has to travel. There are sometimes she had to be moving different places. But despite of all that, she will come. Despite of all that, she kept serving God. And even when sometimes she had nothing at all, even nothing to eat, nothing, she will still serve God. She did not quit on God. She did not turn around and say, now where is God? Where is God? But she kept persisting. The Bible says, for the joy that was set before him, he was willing to endure the cross. That is what happened. For the suffering that you went through is not compared. And when you hear says, you know, she can move around the kitchen, it tells you the kitchen is big. I'm telling you, when you hear her say that she can move from, listen, your mind must be practical. When she says, I can move from one side of the kitchen to another, she's telling you something. You know what it is for her to be moving around from one place, I'm telling you. Don't you not give God glory for that?
Yes, I do.
No. Listen. Do you understand what she said? And for that reason, because she's telling me she has been to the kitchens where she cannot turn around. Am I speaking to somebody here? You know, you should see things how God sees things. God sees things in what? In details. When she said that I can move from that side to the other side, it is listen to me. That one, you don't even need to think twice. The kitchen is huge. And for that, we give God the glory. You know what it is for some people like us, we are tall, to sleep on a bed where your toes are not outside. Am I talking to somebody here right now? Where your feet are not what? Sometimes you sleep, the toes are what? And the feet are what? Plus the winter. But when you're sleeping comfortable and you feel in the bed and the bed is big enough, you give God what? You give God what?
The glory.
You give God what?
The glory.
So you need to understand and you can see. It's important what God has done in life. But you know one thing? It's a good thing about it. She never complained. She kept serving. And yet she was going through some things. What can you say, Pastor?
Man of God is amazing. You just have to keep believing and holding on, because there's a waiting time between your miracle, between where you are and the miracle. And the waiting time, man of God, can I say something?
Yes, go ahead.
You know, this waiting time can be very, you know, something. I don't want to use the bad word, man of God. Because you get a lot of temptation to complain, to nag, to murmur, even to stop serving. Because I remember there was a time when I was in the waiting time. I applied for so many jobs. You know when we were in Lone Street?
Yes.
That is 2007. And I couldn't get a job. I removed all my university degrees from my CV so that I would look like a cleaner, man of God. Even apply for a cleaning job, I couldn't get nothing. So I came to you complaining. I said, Bishop, I've paid my tithe, I've paid my offering, I've done all this, and I can't get a job. You look at me and say, stop complaining, shut up. See, that was a test. It was a long time. I couldn't get a job. But you know, there was a job waiting for me. So you said I should go and repent. That was the prayer. You didn't even pray for me. You just said, shut up, stop complaining. You just complain. Go and repent. Man of God, I went to repent. After that, I got 3 jobs. I put my proper CV. I got 3 jobs in 2 weeks.
In 2 weeks?
Yes.
And high paying jobs.
And high paying jobs.
Top of the world.
Yes. So if we are in the waiting time, she still kept serving. We must still keep doing what we are doing, the way we are doing it, without complaining. And then the miracle will come.
Pastor, look at this. Yes. She said, man of God,
yes,
I've always desired a red kitchen.
A red kitchen.
That's not normal.
Yes.
To desire such a kitchen. A red. And exactly. She received one phone call.
Yes.
And the kitchen was red. That is a sign from God that the miracle is from God. And this is your covenant seed. The affliction shall not rise up for a second time. And you are going to graduate, and we are going to celebrate your degree, and we are going to celebrate your wedding, and we are going to celebrate.
And man of God, that was the instruction you gave to her as well. You gave her this instruction to sow Isaiah 60, verse 18. That was the instruction. Out of disaster seed.
Can you explain that? I told this lady she came to see me. And what did I tell you? Yes, go ahead.
You told me to sow Isaiah 60, verse 18.
Which is Isaiah 60, verse 18, which is no longer shall violence be had in your land. No ruin or destruction within your borders, but you will call your wall salvation and your gates of praise. You know, one thing is amazing. You all know about that seed. Every time when you are in a disaster, when you find that you are in a financial disaster, when you find that you are facing a health crisis, sow that seed. It's an amazing. That is the seed you can sow again and again and again. Now, can you imagine this woman? She's actually going through a situation. And I tell her, so where did you get the money? But what she did, out of everything, despite of everything, even sometimes not having transport, she still went ahead and obeyed and sowed that seed. Part of that seed, she has college all paid for. Now she's rich. But man coming through. She has a big house. Now for the next 2 years, 3 years, everything is all taken care of. All what she has to do now is just study, graduate. After that, by the time she's finished, she's buying that house and buy another one. Give Jesus a mighty the praise, right? Stretch up. Father, we thank you for that testimony. Your faith, my daughter, has made thee whole. Receive it. Give Jesus a mighty praise.